the Four Horsemen, the enforcers of the Charred Council. They count the strongest individuals in the Darksiders universe. Even nowadays, there is no definitive answer to the question of who of them is the strongest. I also won't answer this question in today's video because when I started it, I had something entirely different in mind. Namely, being Strife, War and Fury alone. So, no death here for the first two or three quarters of the video. I'll focus on these three and put them into a game. And we all know this game. It is called Rock, Paper, Scissors. We all played it during our childhood, and we all hated the extreme version of it, where your best buddy clapped you in the face, punched your shoulder, and twisted your arm. Anyways, back to Rock, Paper, Scissors. You all know the rules of the game. Rock crushes scissor, scissor cuts paper, paper covers rock. This rule system I'll now apply to the horsemen. So, let's start with Rock. And who would be more fitting for that than War himself? The youngest of the horsemen is the one who I would describe as the tank of the group. He is portrayed as the bulky, strong and overall massive guy, which is even portrayed in his skills like Stone Skin, Rampage and Earth Splitter. Still, in the early parts of Darksiders 1, he was able to rip apart Tiamat's wings just by using his pure strength. And this was War in his still relatively weakened state. He was also able to punch Thelita through several floors and was even without acceleration able to punch through the skin of the Chosen Ones to rip apart their hearts. He's able to lift heavy objects and, as mentioned before, he can punch creatures much larger than him and make them fly a fair amount of distance, which was also seen with Tiamat. This all should already be enough to assume that War's main attributes are his strength and defensive capabilities. There are plenty more feats, but I'm sure you could consider him the strongest in terms of pure strength amongst the horsemen. Strife, the trickster of the Four Horsemen, represents paper. Why that is? I'll come to that later. Strife is sadly the only horseman who has yet to get his own game. But Genesis provided us with enough information about his abilities so that we can get quite a good glance on his skills and attributes. Genesis shows Strife as the fast and tricky guy. He's a ranged fighter, and this is very obvious. Strife possesses two daggers, but these are not even named and are only an emergency method if opponents come too close. He uses caltrops to maintain distance between himself and his enemies while dealing devastating damage to his opponents. With his ammunition types or abilities like World Ender, which could possibly have the highest attack potency in the franchise. With his shadow clones, he's also able to hold his enemies on distance and under constant pressure and damage. As mentioned before, Strife's main attributes focus on speed and range, but also his overwhelming destructive capabilities. Scissor follows up, which leads us to the magician Fury. Fury is lore-wise the magician of the horsemen. This was stated in many sequences of Genesis and also portrayed in her own game, which leads us to her main attribute. Magic. She specializes in elemental magic as seen in her Hollow forms, which she was gifted by the Lord of Hollows. Although I have a problem with that statement, as she has not portrayed any sort of abilities in terms of magic in the comics. There was not even a little hint for her powers, so the only thing we have for her are the Hollow forms, which she did not possess before they were gifted by the Lord of Hollows, obviously. But this is not that important, because for this video, we will use Hollow Fury. Her second main attribute is her agility and versatility, which is tied to her Hollow forms. Her weapon Scorn and its variations give her an advantage above most fighters, ranged fighters in particular. She can also use telekinesis, which was shown against the constructs in the void. Now, after discussing each of the horsemen, we shall get to the main part of the video, which was the game Rock, Paper, Scissors. Let us now put each of them into their position and discuss how the battle would go between each of them. And let us start with the Rock, aka War. He would absolutely crush Fury in a 1v1 fight. This was, for one, shown in the Darksiders comic. On the other hand, Fury has not enough fighting capabilities to defeat War. Yes, she did not have her holo forms, but nonetheless was absolutely crushed by War when she used her whip on him. Second, even with her force holo, I doubt that she would be able to overwhelm War in terms of pure strength. Yes, it is said that the force holo quote-unquote holds the raw power of force itself, but I personally found these facts, statements, whatever, even if they might be true, very vague, as there are powers in the Darksiders verse which exceed forces like power, fire or stasis. So in conclusion, the Rock crushes our Scissor Fury. But to give our Scissor credit, Fury would absolutely destroy Strife. This is because Strife is a ranged fighter and is not able to keep up with Fury's magic abilities for once, and second, Fury's whip is just a negator of Strife, because as we've seen in Darksiders 3, Fury can pull enemies towards her with her whip, which would force Strife to fight in close combat, and in this aspect I see them as pretty much equal, with Fury having the slight advantage because of her scoring variations. As you can see, the paper has been cut. But before I move to our paperboy Strife, I just want to make it clear that none of the horsemen beats the other with low or mid difficulty. Maybe death with mid or high, but the other three are always beating each other with extreme high difficulty, as they are all pretty much equal in power. Anyways, back to Strife and to maybe the most controversial opinion I'll bring up in this video. That being, Strife beats War in a pretty, don't want to say one-sided way, but that's pretty much what I want to say. The reasons for that are the simple facts that War on one hand is a close combat fighter, and on the other has nothing to balance or even the fight out. His Chaos Hero enhancements are all useless against Strife, maybe except for Earth Splitter, but I don't know if even Earth Splitter will do something. Strife on the other hand has a lot more to offer. Him being faster gives him the advantage of maintaining the distance. If War gets too close, he uses his caltrops or just simply dodges. Strife could have a tough time getting through War's stone skin, but at the end of the day, War has no way of reaching Strife, except if he uses the grappling hook right. But as a side note, if War gets his hands on Strife and holds him tight, it would be over for Strife instantly, because War would just crush his bone structure with his Tremor Gauntlet. But now to the most important question. Why did I not include Death in that system? Well, I didn't simply because Death cannot be scaled together with the other horsemen. His powers are completely different in comparison to the other horsemen. He is a combination of the other three horsemen, but his power in itself, how he represents the other's strength, is different. Fury is the best example. Lore-wise, she is the magic user of the four, and now that she possesses the holoforms, I can't deny that fact. But there are different types of magic in the universe of Darksiders. There is the magic of the Makers, the holoforms, the necromancy that Death uses, and many others. The spectrum is just simply too wide and deserves a video on its own. Death uses, as I already mentioned, necromancy, but this is only one of his many other magic types. He got enhancing magic, defensive magic, necromancy and many more. This stuff alone would make Death kinda a stronger magic user in comparison to Fury. At least that's what you would think, right? Well, technically yes, but no. Fury specializes in elemental magic as shown in her holoforms, while Death uses a completely different type of it. But let's move on for now and focus on the rest later. Which brings me to War. War has the upper hand in terms of strength when compared to Death. Or does he? Well, yet again yes, but again no. War has tremendous strength feats and would most likely body Death in a fist fight, but there is one thing that Death possesses that kinda cancels War's strength advantage, this being that Death literally has some sort of stand, and this being his Reaper magic, and sort of. His ability to create some sort of magical limbs is quite overpowered. I mean, Death is the only one of all the horsemen who didn't need some sort of gauntlet or force hollow to move heavy objects. He had that ability from the start, and that is what makes Death so insanely strong, because you need to remember, it was an unsanctioned mission, Doug. It was an unsanctioned mission. It was an unsanctioned mission in Darksiders 2. And still he portrays feats War and Fury needed equipment for. War is also kind of the most defensive rider, and even in that category Death shines with his Aegis Shield and his ability Unstoppable, which boosts his power. And not only protects Death, but also deals damage to his opponents as well. But let's move to Strife now. Strife is the only horseman Death does not counter as heavy as the other two. As Strife focuses on agility, traps, tricks, and obviously his speed, Death is able to combine his previous abilities to counter the traps and tricks. But Teleport Slash technically negates Strife's speed advantage, as teleportation is pretty much instantly and has a very wide range. And Strife, mostly being a ranged fighter, has quite a disadvantage in close combat. Yes, he got his daggers, but come on, do you really think he could take down Death in a close combat 1v1 situation? I highly doubt it. I hope it is now much clearer to you why Death was technically excluded from this, as he is very much balanced in every regard. He doesn't have one specific attribute, his abilities and skills revolve around, he is perfectly balanced.